Good morning, everyone. We're at the Cleveland Museum of Art, and we're giving you guys a little Christmas over and undertone here. Now, in a minute, we're going to go in and show you guys some amazing items you can get for anyone on your Christmas list. But first, we're at the Cleveland Museum of Art, so we have to show you some tremendous art. Good morning, Steve. And that's where you come in. How are
you? Welcome to the Cleveland Museum of Art.
Thank you so much. All right, we're going to segue into the Focus Gallery, and you guys have a really neat exhibit here.
Thank you. We focus on a single object from the museum's medieval collection. Mm-hmm. It's known as a table fountain.
A table fountain.
This object survives against all odds. It's the only surviving complete example of a medieval table fountain from the Middle Ages.
Wow.
So if you want to see one, you have to come to Cleveland.
The only one in the world.
Wow. It was made in Paris 700 years ago in the early 1300s, mm-hmm. and as you can see, it's architecturally shaped. It's really what we call an automaton. It's a functioning object. It has little rotating wheels. It has ringing bells.
Mm-hmm. And go ahead. So to give people perspective, Jim is going to show you guys have a really nice video of what one would look like if it was on a dinner table.
We created this animation some years ago to give our visitors an impression of actually what it would have looked like when operating. But here's the thing, Kenny. They were never used on banqueting tables.
Really?
Early scholars who studied these objects thought they were used on banqueting tables, but I think more likely they would have been used in vestibules or interior courtyards, probably standing on a pedestal, because it would have required a permanent plumbing fixture.
I see.
With a supply line and a drain.
We
know from medieval inventories that they used perfumed water, rose water, so it would have been in a very elegant room center. They were objects of spectacle and entertainment, and they were very, very high status symbols.
And how long do you think it would take an artist or a craftsman to make one of these?
Well, this was made by a master goldsmith in Paris, and he probably had a very large shop with assistants and journeymen and apprentices working with him. Something like this, it's made with bent sheets of gilt silver.
Wow.
Some of the parts are cast, so it probably would have taken months to cast and assemble an object like this. And you'll notice also there are translucent enamels, which was a very, very expensive form of art.
Steve, thank you
so
much.
My pleasure.
Perspective. Yeah, so that you think about the more craftsmanship went into building a car than the building a car.
That's right.
That's exactly.
All right, Steve, thank you so much.
My
appreciate
pleasure,
that.
Danny.
All right,
you
guys, when we come back, we're going to do a little Christmas shopping here at the Cleveland Museum of Art.
I just saw the gift, and I'm going to get my partner's.
Oh.
Sitting right there.
You might not be able to afford that for Christmas or a Christmas gift.
No,
I don't know.
He can.
I'm just saying.
He can.